Everybody, it's Victor. It's time to continue streak here, the Binding of Isaac Victor Repentance series. Yesterday's video has not crossed 5,000 likes yet, but the previous one did, continuing the trend of this week, going on into the weekend now. We're sitting in the double digits for the first time on the new like streak goal. Thank you all very much for making it possible. As always, one third of the way now towards all random week. I cannot wait for it. Here's your meme of the day. This one brought to you by Northern Star Keel. Title thread was Thusmas meme. If you know, you know. Time Traveler moves chair. The timeline. Yeah, you have to watch this week's Thusmas in order to understand what you're talking about. If you missed the Pokemon challenge, go check it out. I mean, personally, of course, we got to take a little sissy on that one. She's got to be the best starter Pokemon, you know? She uses that charm energy, and next thing you know, you got everyone on your side. It is going to be Romeo 4, November Sierra 1-6, Juliet 6. Can we actually get an upgrade in today's run? That's going to be the question of the day. We're starting off with Tammy's Head and Keebum. We've got good tiers, kind of bad damage to start with, but, you know, that's just par for the course here. Random Soul Heart dropping here. Yeah, I'm going to stick with Tammy's Head. I'm going to touch the How to Jump cartridge just so we can get a chance to get Bookworm. Obviously, Tammy's Head is a big-time player if you make big-time plays, especially if you have good tier effects. Right now, we don't have any tier effects, so it's not going to matter that much. But, of course, if you did something like Brimstone, I mean, Brimstone obviously is going to be that is the item that you want with Tammy's Head. You know, when you get Tammy's Head, what do? You just hope for Brimstone. Oh, man, Keeper Sack. If we can somehow get Keeper Sack for this, we might have ourselves a winner. Emperor card here as well. You know, we won't have to worry about getting item upgrades because we've got Keeper Sack. Of course, that is contingent on us actually getting, like, you know, money to pay for keepers, for the money for us to get the bonuses. Oh, wow, it's not there. For us to get Keeper Sack. But if we can end up buying our upgrades in the store, then, you know, hey, they're upgrades. They're damage upgrades, tiers upgrades, movement upgrades. I mean, Keeper Sack gives you everything. I thought hopefully maybe that would actually hit the super secret room. We get Black Candida. Oh my gosh, we're going to be able to get Keeper Sack. Let's go. Let's go. And we're going to also have two bombs left over as well that we can use for other things. So Keeper Sack, Black Candle, and floor number one. Now, what's very interesting about this as well is that we could also buy the Keeper's Box, and that would also theoretically give us a chance to give ourselves even more upgrades. Because we would be able just to simply spawn shops and then buy them. But again, that's all that is contingent on us actually having enough money to afford the items that drop. Or at least that are displayed by the Keeper's Box, so the little portable shop. So this is really interesting. We are assuming that we get enough money, we will be able to get upgrades on this run. I know it's like a Christmas miracle, man. Hopefully, breaking the trend of our 2-day streak of just horrible runs. I honestly had to stop myself. I stopped and thought about it for a little while, whether or not I wanted to highlight, like, you know, the negative parts of a run. But when you've got a run that's like nothing but negative in one way or another in terms of like what's going on and stuff, it's like I gotta make a meme out of this. I gotta make some, but you know, we gotta add some humor into it. And congrats to those of you in the mosh pit who picked up on the play on words for the S tier play on words. I'm glad that some of y'all were smart enough to catch that. I'm actually not going to buy anything. I'm going to stick with Tammy's Head. Because if we end up getting a good amount of tier effects with Tammy's Head, we can ball out of control, and especially if we end up getting something like Brimstone. I'm not planning on that. I'm not, like, you know, banking on that, but at the same time, it would be nice. The Keeper's Box play is, it really does hinge on us being able to actually get enough money to afford to buy whatever drops. And yes, that would be an on-call stat upgrade. All right, I'll do it. I'll do it. I'll do it because if we end up getting a lot of money, then it could make more sense. So there you go. So we've got a movement speed upgrade, a huge damage upgrade, and a range upgrade. All right. Thank you, Tammy's Head. Maybe next run. All right, here we go. So yeah, so we don't have to, obviously we don't have to take the pills, but anything that Keeper's Box drops, we're essentially giving ourselves stats. I decided to go against the Tammy's head play at the last second just because like we haven't had a chance to get this combo. And in a way, it's kind of like a portable stat vendor. We can rest assured as long as we have money, we can get stat ups. We don't have to worry about the game not giving us anything that we need. So now there is also one little turd in the punch bowl, and that is if Keybum takes all of our keys, you know, and we end up not being able to get any golden chest or stores or anything like that, then, you know, the effectiveness of Keeper Sack dips dramatically. But here's to hoping that we don't have to worry about that. We have Conehead, which is going to give us a soul heart. And just trying to get away from these jerks. Arrow card, okay. The name of the game is money. Dinero. Moolah. Cold hard cash. Because if that happens, if we happen to just, if we get a whole lot of money, man, like our stat woes are no more and I got stuck on the pot. Another Emperor card.
Two of clubs.
Really, really hoping that was going to give us a soul heart. We can make up for the lack of that black heart that we just lost. Now we still need to get into the store. I'm going to use a bomb here on Gemini. Make things a little bit easier on us. Wow. Okay. Oh, the schmoves are out. I don't think we can go devil deals, unfortunately. Not with 1 HP. Can we get into the store? We can. Okay, hopefully we get a nickel here. Not only that, we got an extra penny. Ooh, Pandora's box would give us two keys and two bombs. We just need 5 cents, but there's also a chance that we can get a bomb from here and go into the boss trap room. Okay, we lost HP. We gained everything else but movement speed. And in the span of one item, we've gotten more stats than we did in the last, I think, two runs combined. Need to be very cautious against Gurglings here, especially if the schmoves are out in force today. A DPS and Gurgling separately is not what you want to do. You want to take them down as fast as possible. The least amount of Gurglings flying all over the place, the better for you, I promise. Okay, so I think what we do is we buy Pandora's Box for the big upgrade, and then we go buy the tarot card. If we can afford it. We probably can't afford it now. Nope. All right, never mind. We got movement speed, damage, and range. Had to beat Keybum to the punch. Hangman. Hangman might be okay. Let's go see if we can get something with this Hangman card. I'm hoping like there's like a locked room that just has a bunch of chests in it, that but we can only get there if we fly, sort of thing. We could use the hangman card to get out of the cursed room. Super secret room might be to the right, or might be to the south of this room, but I gotta go look at that other room that we haven't been in yet. I know, some of you are saying, well, why don't you just keep him and take a key? He might be able to give you a chest. Yeah, I mean, that's true, he could, but he probably won't. Got two bombs I'm gonna try here. We're going to end up not getting... It's too much of a risk to go into the curse room on one half heart with... Yeah, it's not going to happen. We still could go in the devil deal, but at this point, obviously, we would just simply die. So I think that we gotta say no. Oh, baby. Now we're talking. Hard against humanity is an excellent way if we can somehow get the petrified poop as an excellent way for us to solve our money woes. We're buying our way up. I will allow Keybum to get one singular key. We do have a big room in here, so. Be careful of the champions here. Tempting, but I want to wait. Again, I don't trust our... Did anybody see this trite? Just skip over that. I saw that game. 100% saw that. You can't hide that. Go back and replay the tape. I saw that trite over here. I saw it teleport across this way. And on something new today. And now is when we need the hangman. Unfortunately, we cannot take this. I mean, we could if we get a red heart. Ghost Pepper would be very, very good. Okay, so the bad gas mushroom was able to poison that one. But we're not gonna be able to take not gonna be able to get these keys. Also, that was stupid for breaking that poop. Key bum. Better hook us up with something. We just need 3 cents, game. We need 2 cents for the card against humanity. Steam sale is huge! Yeah, we can get the card against humanity. And then we have to charge forward to get Steam Sale. That playing card could be interesting as well if that's a two of diamonds, but we've got to use... We have to go buy... There's no way that we're going to get another XL room, at least not one that's bigger than what we already have. So let's go pick up the card against humanity. We're going to use it inside the big room. It gave us a slight movement speed upgrade. Thank you. 300th of a... speed upgrade. Now, we gotta hope that we get the petrified poop. Come on. If not petrified poop, then a whole lot of money. I'm not going to pop the poops that are inaccessible for us right now, because I can totally see the game doing a thing where it will spawn the petrified poop like on there and we can't get to it. Don't even act like you don't know that Isaac wouldn't do that. Yeah, we can go get ghost pepper. Petrified poop, we need you. If we're not going to get petrified poop, then at least give us a ton of money here, game. Yeah, I hesitated really bringing to light how bad those runs were, but it's been a very long time, if not ever, since we've ever had a pair of back-to-back horrible runs, like just one after the other. So, and I wanted to, because I did the first, this is a crappy run title, I wanted to go with the play on words for the S tier run. I'm glad that people were able to catching on to that one. But highlighting the negative of runs is not something that I tend to do, especially in the thumbnails and stuff. But that was, those two were a pair, let me tell you that. And if you haven't seen those runs yet, you owe it to yourself to go watch it, because yeah, you think that you get some bad runs. I mean, a lot of people are like, finally Zinvicta gets a bad run, like I do. Yeah, I get bad runs quite often, in fact. Go back and pick up this, no, we want to go, where was that playing card? It wasn't in here. This was our Emperor card, right? Yeah. And so we can get into the curse room for basically free here. Get a soul heart. I don't want to lose this soul heart. I decided to use the Emperor card here. Because we're going to have to lose it. We're going to have to lose that soul heart anyway. Before, like, I really should not have picked up the soul heart. What I should have done is should have gone out, gotten ghost pepper, come back, picked up the soul heart, and then used the Emperor card. But it's a moot point if we get an Angel Deal anyway, so. Well, actually, no, it's not. We still lose the soul heart. That was a misplay. Definite misplay. Do get some of our movement speed back that we lost from experimental treatment, so I'm happy about that. Wow, okay. Okay, 5 cents to pay dirt, or 6 cents to pay dirt, rather. And we know that we have that sticky nickel in the Guardians Humanity room. This room was way harder than it should have been. Here we go. Or we don't have to lose it and use. Wait, no, never mind. Yeah, we have to lose it. Whatever. All right. So we need 1 cent. 1 cent to get. To get Steam Sale. Again, Steam Sale is significant here because it not only does it cut the cost of everything in half, but also we get full benefits for half price things as well, especially for half price premium items. We just gained a whole lot of damage and good range. And now we just need 2 cents to get this, which could be a two of diamonds, which could be, actually massive. I'm not gonna use Keeper's Box anymore on this floor because we've already pretty much explored everything. I do still want to go into this room here and get a whole lot of nothing. All right, Keybum, I'm going to let you take over for a little bit. So if we get any keys, Keybum, it's all you. I'm going to give you a chance to be a big-time player. But just know this, that you're on the scout team right now, son. You're under evaluation. All right, I need you to post up some big time plays here. Yeah, see that wasn't a big time play. All you did was just take a key from me. See, so now I gotta go find more keys for you to take, like some kind of chump. Let's not lose this bone heart. Let's go back into the room here. Let's go fill that back up. You know the petrified poop sitting on that corner right over there. You know it is. Don't even act like you don't know. You know it's there. You know the game just waited to spawn it over where we can't get to it. Okay, so we are going to be able to get that that playing card. Hopefully it's a two of diamonds or an ace of diamonds. An ace of diamonds would also not be horrible for this room here. I'm going to leave my half heart on right now just in case if it's an ace of diamonds. And by leave my half heart on, I mean I'm not going to go fill up with another heart. Instead, I'm going to leave myself on half of a heart. Queen of Hearts is not helpful unless we find an arcade or a temperance machine or something like that. I'm going to hold on to the Queen of Hearts. Fine. Okay. I know it would have killed everyone out there for me not to destroy those poops just to see the audacity of the game. There's too many places. We're going to need this bomb. There's too many places that our secret room could be. Okay, we got another bone heart here. I'd love to preserve it if possible. In fact, I'm going to use Queen of Hearts now just so we don't lose it. Got a soul heart, okay. Probably should have left the soul heart there. Yep. And that's the reason why right there. Literally just... That's the reason why, right there. All right. What we call the good old classic repentance double tap. Secret room's got to be south of this room here, as it should be.
Have you learned nothing? You literally just said don't pick up a soul heart.
Yeah, well, I'm angry. I want to have my soul heart back. It only cost me 3 cents and we get stats for it, so whatever. Good. I would love to get a tears up. You know, if we could have some directed... If we could have some directed level of stat... That I could point at and be like, hey, I want that stat. You know, now is when I'd be pointing towards the tiers up sheet. Be like, yeah, I'd like to re-up on this one, please. If I could just get a singular tiers up to start with game, either by way of item or by way of me buying said item. Maybe not said item, just buying a item. Champion belt is fantastic. Half price champion belt. Yeah, this was definitely the right call. Going with Keeper's Box over Tammy's head, definitely 100% the right call. I'm glad that I decided to do that, because, man. I'm going to let Ghost Pepper take down these Keepers here. Again, the more money we get, the better. It's 7 cents per premium item right now. Every 7 cents, we get a massive, massive stat up. That's the power of Keeper's Sack. There's a key for you there, Keybum. There you go, buddy. Right there. That one just right there. Let's see if you can be a big time player, son. Another range upgrade. We didn't take damage from either one of those cursed doors. If you're wondering how is that possible, it's because of Conehead. So we got exceedingly lucky right there. There we go. Get a little bit of movement speed upgrade. All right. You know, it's all right. All right. I'm buying what you're putting down, game. $0.04 for a bomb. That's like a... It's like a fairly good withdrawal from a donation machine. I don't know if you could tell that I was like nodding my head there. It was like, you know, yeah, I feel you. That 80% miss on the Angel Deal game. I feel you. Fully cognizant of the fact that, like, literally no one can see me right now. So, yeah, 80% Angel Deal. How's that working for us, Isaac? Working real good? Working super there, bud? Dude, Hollow Heart's been just crushing it for us. Just got our portable stat vendor. Really, it's a stat machine. Not a slot machine, it's a stat machine here. One that makes you larger pill. It could be there, I'd be surprised. Another speed upgrade, huge speed upgrade. Damage now sitting at 10.95. That is just... you love to see it. Oh, is that the shiny clinking sound of a dime I hear? I think it is. I think it is, Keybum. $0.03 for one bomb is like a bad withdrawal, so I'm not going to take it. I mean, I guess, like, Proptosis isn't anywhere near as good as it used to be anymore. Let's just get that out of the way right now. The nerf hit Proptosis something fierce. Oh, look at freaking Sasuke over here. So close range, our damage is going to be absolutely incredible. Far range is another matter entirely. So now's when you would want something like a Mom's Knife, something like a Brimstone, something that you could use that scales off of, that scales very greatly off of damage. Particularly the close quarter combat damage of Proptosis. That's what we're looking for right now. Beautiful. Still have not found the actual shop yet, and it's gonna be our friend Gish. Oh my god. Ghost Pepper just ate Gish's lunch, and that is not the Star of Bethlehem, that is Eden Soul. How great would it be if there's a full charge in here? You thought it was for a second. Yeah, we're not taking Eden Soul. The backpack would have also been kind of nice. I'm absolutely in love with this run. I mean, here we are with a combo. I don't know why I went the path of most resistance there. Here we are with a combo that, you know, is not even one that you would even think about until it was presented to you. And that is how you make. Oh, there's our full charge. And if we keep getting, if we just keep spawning full charges, we're just getting more and more stats. But that is how you make an interesting item in Isaac. Something like Keeper's Sack. There's so much potential there. And you're seeing it here live. Humbling Bundle's huge. Yeah, this is getting out of control. Maybe Keeper's Sack just can't give you tears up. It might be too much fun. It's still a very powerful, very broken item. In all the right ways. Don't say it too loud now. We don't. This is our secret, you know. Don't be no kind of narc over there. We're having fun here. We're just minding our business, having a good time with these stat ups that we're just feeding ourselves. This is our little secret. You don't want to ruin the fun, do you? Do you? Oh, we have no money. Probably going to use the Hoggler's Rune in that other room that has those 3 cents in there. Okay, 10 keys. I'm willing to let Keybum take some big time play chances here. Hey. And even at the damage downscale of Proptosis at that far range, we're still one-shotting things. That's pretty incredible there. Let's see if there is a crawl space. Probably not. Ah. Thought maybe it would be there. Usually the secret room is to the left of here, but I know it's not. And the super secret room, I'd venture a guess. I don't think it's over here. But I'll try it. I'm going to save our bombs for another store here. We'll head on to town. I'm loving this run. This is great. This is a fun combo. Oh, sorry, Keybum. All right. I'll give you a chance. I'm going to let you have a chance, son. I'll let you have a chance to make some big time plays, but you got to make the big time plays in order for you to make the big time plays. See, if you want to be what we like to call around here a big time player, then you got to make the big time plays. All right. You not making big time plays means that you're not a big time player. Do you want to be a big time player or not? You do? Okay, well, the next key you get, I want to see a chest. I want to see something substantial come out of there, okay? I'll do my part. I'll do my part. I will give you the key. But you got to do the work. I can't do the work for you, son. I can only put you in the position that allows you to be the best that you can be. Be the best key bum you can be. But you got to go the rest of the way. Look, I know you said I said I was going to give you the key, but it was a charge key. That doesn't count. Spider Bite's excellent. Excelente. Mooey excellent. Trey excelente. I need to start throwing. We need to start peppering more German into the Sinvicta-ish. Sinvictis. Not sure what you would call my languages. Okay, funds are starting to become a little bit of an issue, but if we get a withdrawal machine here and not a greed fight, like if we're looking at the four, with Humbling Bundle, we should be able to get a fair bit amount. Booster pack is very good. Coupon doesn't really do anything for us here. In fact, it's counterintuitive for us. With diamonds, now we're talking. Yeah, but you gotta give us like money. Donation machine, we hardly knew ye. All right, it won't hurt for too much longer. We just gotta get to 49, 48, 49 cents. Then we Gucci. See, it's not 48 or 49 cents, see. We could go double this now. I don't remember where those bombs were. They were, we spawned two bombs somewhere on this floor, but I don't remember where. I could just go back and look for them, but who's got that kind of time? Who am I kidding? We all do. Literally everyone listening to this video has that kind of time. We're over here somewhere. Item room? No. Well, those are hearts. Oh yeah, we don't need bombs. Maybe I'm just thinking of the last floor then, I guess. There you go, Keybum. Have at it. Now's your chance, son. Now's your chance. Don't blow it. Yeah, look at that. Keybum. It only took you 3 keys to do so, but you did it. Good job, son. See, that's how you step up. That's all we want from you. You've taken the first steps to becoming a bigger time player. Really wish we had 95 cents, though, but what can we do? Chaos card, hermit card. Double chaos card. Yeah, so we're just going to use that. Take the chaos card. Do that. Take the good old negative. Oh, you know we're doing a victory lap. This is too much fun. No way we don't do a victory lap on the run like this. Mm-mm. Hierophant, nice. I swear I killed you over here already. There we go. Finally get a bomb. Not that it really matters anymore because there's no more stores, at least not on this run. Unless we count Old Hushy, which we could, but look at that. That cost us 1 cent right there. Now seeing at 14.30 damage. And this is just getting more and more out of control every time we buy something. But we really want to start getting premium items here. I think it would have been nice for us to be able to go into Hush and fight him twice for the extra stores. But we're still getting quality upgrades here from Keeper Sack and Keeper's Box. Not going to go in the curse room. Even though we have a guppy item, we don't have Devil Deal precedent, so not really too caring about curse rooms at this point. I mean, Matriarch, and we've already chunked away over half of her health. Good little block there by Conehead. And oh man, Soul Heart Bonanza. Look at all these Soul Hearts dropping. It's beautiful. Get an Eternal Heart and 80, another 80% deal that we failed. That's good stuff right there. Good stuff. I need the math whizzes of the mosh pit to come out in force now. What are the chances of us failing two independent 80% rolls in one run? I must know. I didn't care about that bone heart, by the way, because I'd rather have that heart slot reserved for a soul heart. Look at that, back up to 99 cents. Oh, baby. This is gorgeous. Guppy's tail. We may actually get Guppy without us even having a Devil Deal precedent, which does happen from time to time. Not very often, but it does. Oh, I saw that one lining up. I saw it lining up. So despite all of our damage, we still don't have incredible tiers because we haven't gotten a single tiers upgrade yet on this first run anyway. Happy Saturday, though. Taking up for the abysmal couple of runs that we've been having lately. Again, just feeding ourselves more and more damage. See, Keybum, I mean, hey, thanks for the chest. Thank you. But I need you to pay out with something. See, I need those chests that you're paying out with to have something in there. Not pills. See, I can give myself pills, and it doesn't cost me keys. What I need you to do, son, is I need you to give us some of them golden chests. Golden chests or red chests, and we're square. Now, steel chests are fine, but if that's what you're going to be paying out with, then I need you to understand something, son. I need you to be giving me some of them. Oh, man. some of them good drops. We're talking about, you know, Hierophant cards, Emperor cards, that sort of thing. Two of diamonds, of course. Man, when Ghost Pepper fires off like that, close range of Proptosis, good lord, stand back. Circle protection, ladies. Death card will hold on to. That's what I'm talking about, Keybum. Look at that. Giving us our first tiers upgrade of the entire freaking run. Beautiful. Getting the screw from Keybum. Who'da thunk it, man? We don't want either one of those, but who'da thunk that one? Now that's a big time play right there, son. That's what I'm talking about. That's what gets you on the team. That's what gets you picked up instead of passed over. Charge, baby. Get some more range out of this. Look at that. Soul Heart, I'm telling you. I'm liking the effort. Not liking it, I'm loving it. Ba-da-da-da-da. It's like on the corner because we're moving way too fast. I do have to get some keys though, Keybum. Oh man, second Steam sale would have been incredible. Pay to win is also extremely good. Though it does slightly hurt our buying power. For the next run, that's going to be huge for us in the item rooms. Get yourself another 0.25 damage just from buying a pill. And we have a two of diamonds on deck. I mean, this is good stuff here. We get a mom's underwear. That's the dream right there, is having Ghost Pepper fire off as soon as Fallen spawns into their game. Proptosis was definitely a pretty big call there. I'm glad that we picked it up. Some bombs will head on down. All right, we're one Guppy Adam away from Guppy somehow. Lusty Blood wouldn't be bad. Sin Robes are also fantastic. Sitting now at a whole lot of damage. .16 damage. Every time we kill an enemy thanks to Lusty Blood, we're going to get even more damage out of that. Now, every time Keybum drops a chest in here, it's going to result in a guaranteed item unless if it's a red chest. So, Keybum, thank you, Battery Baby. It's very kind of you. Keybum, anything but a red chest, and we're happy. If it's going to be a red chest, then at least give us Guppy. Didn't mean to pick that up, actually. I tried to back off. You'll notice me try to pull back there at the last second. That was my bad, Keybum. You know, coaches make mistakes every now and then, you know? another one in here? Okay. Thought that was all of them, to be honest. The only reason why I went down there was so we can get more charges on the Keeper's box. Oh, this room's not going to be fun. There we go, 0.44 damage up. I mean, it only takes one ghost pepper fire and enemies just melt. All right, come on, Keybum. Yeah, look at that. I mean, for those guys to die in that quick of a time, you know that we're dealing with some next level damage here. Great job by Circle Protection. What are we talking about, Keybum? But we just got done talking about this, son. Literally any chest but a red chest. Alright. Alright, you got the game plan down now? You got it memorized? I appreciate you paying out, but I need it to be anything but a red chest. And if it's going to be a red chest, it better be a guppy item in there. Flat penny would be huge for Keybum. Hey. I'm willing to stick with this until the end of this floor. But I want to have my pay-to-win trinket for the next run. .14 damage up. I mean, you knew that was going to happen in here. All right, well, I tried to look for other coins. Didn't get any. And Keybum gave us a little brimmy. I can't complain there. Take Zodiac. Justice. Weird that war just went completely invulnerable there. Like when we slowed him down with Spider Bite, it was just like, oh yeah, I'm not going to take any more damage. All right, well. Sorry, Flat Penny, I tried. The body is already dead, and down goes Lamb. Oof, man. Gonna be brutal on the next run. It took us a while to get there, but we did it. Victor Whiskey, 9, Charlie, Mike, 6, Lima, 6. All right. We had one tier upgrade in that entire run, and it was thanks to Keybum, of all things. Keybum, keep doing what you're doing, son. We need more of that. Iron bar is not good enough for us. Whoop de whoop is fantastic. There she be. Now we're talking tiers here. So there's no reason for us to use the two of diamonds right now, ever. Not until we're low on funds, then we can start using them. And if this is any indication for you, I don't think we're going to be running out of money anytime soon. And getting Darkbone would also not be too bad. Yeah, this is the good stuff right here. Trapdoor for world card. And it gives us Empty Heart, which I think we can reroll to something better. Second little Brimmy, no thanks. Aries, meh. Fortune Cookie, meh. Bum Friend, no thank you. Chocolate Milk wouldn't have been horrible, but I probably still wouldn't have taken it. I'll take Evil Eye, I guess. Gaining a whole lot of range, not a whole lot of damage. We're slowly building the funds back up already. Keep thinking that we have flying for some reason. We're not Guppy yet. Hopefully we get Guppy. Not yet, though. Shot speed ain't bad. Wheel of Fortune threatens to re-roll this. No, thank you. Soul of Isaac could be okay for the devil deal. Wait, I don't think it works in the devil deal. It does work in the angel deal, however.
Soul of Isaac.
We go relic here. We could go body. I'm gonna go body. The mother transformation. We're back to 99 cents already. Bloody Lust ain't bad. Not what we're looking for. Teleport. Bozo. Now we learned on tonight's Isaac Madness run that soy milk is actually not affected by the damage downgrade of keeper's sack paying out. So you don't incur the soy milk bonus. The soy milk penalty, I should say, by using Keeper Sack. Whenever you get a Keeper Sack upgrade, it doesn't incur the 30%. Oh my gosh, this might be game crashing here. If we get Jacob's Ladder, which I would love to get Jacob's Ladder, by the way. Get Jacob's Ladder. Eternal D Sizzle, no thank you. Two hearts. Bonehead's still paying out for us and making us avoid taking damage. This is about to get all kinds of out of control. Chariot card. Although we are getting only 0.04 damage up now. Maybe it wasn't Keeper Sack that I was thinking of. We had a damage upgrade that we were getting that did not get affected by the damage down of soy milk. Yes, I almost walked out without getting my two of diamonds. Don't worry, I saw it. Almost too little too late, but I did see it. 35 bombs, it really should be at least checking pot for the quarter. If we can get like 4-1, sure, but 2-1, eh. Luck upgrade here. We will head on to them. This is getting out of control in a hurry now with Jacob's Ladder, Evil Eye proccing as well. That's where the second volley of shots are coming from. Moving a little bit too quick there, Isaac. Whew, man, that damage. But needless to say, our tears are no longer an issue now. Man, and we get Binky anyway, which is going to give us even more tears up. And notice how the electricity is chaining a lot more because we're standing on water. You can be host hat is fan freaking tastic. Now we don't have to worry about explosions of any kind. I mean, this almost looks like we've got like the rules mod on, like we just made this run, but oh no, it's all natural. Now I don't think that we need to use the two of diamonds yet, but if there's a lot of good things in the store, then I may have to at 55 cents. Buy one 1.77 cost item, then we'll go ahead and rip it. Compost would not be bad either. Yeah, there we go. Here we're supporting our local shopkeepers. I could have bought that full charge for the keeper's box, but I chose not to. All right, doing my part. Back up to 91 cents we go. Another energy. Oh, baby. My goodness. What a difference. What a difference a day makes, huh? Holy smokes. That's a planetarium, folks, and that's Mars, which I will not be taking. And we're still one away from Guppy. Now, this one could quite possibly be one of the stronger runs that we've had in a very long time. But I mean, you knew that we were due for one of these, though. Like, you just knew it. After the last 2 days, you just knew that, like, we had good karma coming our way. Surviving those runs like we did, and then to end up here is incredible. Get another angel deal here. And we get deep pockets as well. Man. I do want to go into the store still. Deep pockets now is going to expand our ability to hold more than 99 cents. Yes, I clearly don't care anymore about... We don't have to care about the damage that we are incurring. Oh, my goodness. Actually, I think Kidney Stone would be a huge error. If we had Rock Bottom, then absolutely, but no. Kidney Stone would just... Oh, Cricket's Body! It's actually probably good that we didn't get Cricket's Body. Cricket's Body with this tears rate and Jacob's Ladder, that's a recipe for crashing. Trust me. I've crashed this game more than enough times to see it on the Isaac Madness streams to know that this game will crash if you take Jacob's Ladder and Cricket's Body. Stars card. Stars card. Beast's card. Stars card. Oh, man. And we get the membership card, too. For the run that has everything. Half price wafer. Watch the stats go up crazy here. I'm going to walk out so we reset Bloody Lust and walk back in and just watch this. Okay, well, it wasn't that spectacular. The moon card as well. We get the stairway. Why not? Why not, you know? Why not? Yeah, we need to have more ways to give ourselves stats. I mean, what can I say? The game wants to see it. The game said, you know what? Go nuts today. And you know what, game? We're going to go nuts today. Don't mind if I do. Wow. What a series of events. I mean, we really don't need Keeper's Box anymore, to be quite honest. What were those stars cards in the next room? I know that we had one down there, but I just want to... Again, who's got that kind of time? So we're with the stairway, we're going to get an angel shop on every new floor, and man, oh man. Yeah, the ballin' out of control factor is high right now. Strength card we can use for boss rush, or we can use it for delirium, which is where we're going to be going to after old Hushy. We gotta end this one right. We're just doing our civic duty to check out all the possible stops on the map. You know how it goes. Y'all know how it goes by now. Oh, Four keys, huh? Judgment gives us a reroll machine inside of a room. I'm going to take the flat file. I guess I'll take Seraphim as well. Flat file will make it to where we don't have to worry about not to worry about spikes anymore. Definitely want some money here. Golden doorstop. Sure, why not? We get a screw, which is they give us some shot speed, which we definitely absolutely don't need. Kind of a penny would be nice here. I mean, we don't really need the flat file. I just wanted something to buy. You know, it's nice not having to worry about the about spikes and stuff. I mean, when you got Sacred Heart, Soy Milk, Jacob's Ladder, you're gonna be fine. On in any given situation, you're gonna be fine. That's where we find ourselves. We also find ourselves going in all the wrong ways, and that's fine too. This would only be made better if we had Guppy at this point. T-Bum, I'll let you go back and get those keys. I better see a red chest, and I better see a Guppy item. Aww. Almost called it. That is not bad either. Devil's Crown. So it is, we are already on depths too, so maybe it doesn't matter at this point. We could reroll for a Guppy item in here. I think we do it. Or Babylon's good, but not good enough. Thought that might be Bookworm. Yeah. We'll take the black tooth. Having Guppy would have been very, very nice. We did drop the inverted strength card. That was on the last floor. I mean, we don't really need it anyway, but it would have just kind of been nice. There is our Guppy in the form of kids drawing. All right, we are now complete. Full build has been achieved. Wowee. That is one incredibly powerful Isaac run. We get Divine Intervention as well. We don't... I think Ease Mascara ruins this build. Yes, the damage would be massive, but, I mean, come on. What do we need more damage for at this point? We're doing all right. Hey, moving box. My God. Yeah, that is a all kinds of death in here. What a mess. Looks like we're gonna be going up against Triacnid. Fogatory. I wouldn't mind getting Solok as well, but we don't have the money for it. Fogatory, always welcome to the crew. Yeah, we don't want to drop Guppy's drawing now, because if we drop a child's painting or drawing, then we literally lose Guppy. We don't want that to happen. Is Guppy something that we need? No, we haven't needed anything since we got, you know, so we got Ghost Pepper pretty much, but still nice to have. The little horn is going to just be huge for this. The procs are going to be out of control. That was a haunted chest. I don't know if you saw that or not, but that was indeed a haunted chest there for a second. Now he goes Triacnid, then we get Pentagram as well. Not a big damage up. I gotta say, it's not looking good for old Hushy or Delirium or any boss in the game for that matter. Just if you're a boss in this game, you're about to not be. You're about to be a dead in this game is what you're about to be. No, there's no force on this green earth that's gonna make me try to reroll this run or possibly chance it or anything. That's not happening. Ancient Recall.
Ancient Recall.
Let me go Magician card. Not that we need it because we have Sacred Heart anyway, but might as well. Yeah. I think that was less than a second. Definitely not the most exciting item rooms here with milk, rock in a jar, Mom's Eyeshadow, and Friend Zone. Alabaster Box. Nothing, huh? All right, let's see how old Hushy does. 2143 is when we began. And it was 20 seconds later and Hush was dead. 20 seconds later. Man, that is a powerful Isaac run. You know, you gotta love it. You just gotta love it. We are on our victory lap, and after all the trials and tribulations we went through yesterday and the day before, I think that we kind of deserve a run like this, and it's been quite the run. And it really does go to show you like how many interesting things you can find in repentance is just few and far between in terms of like, you know, synergies and whatnot. And this is definitely one of those premier synergies that you're not going to find a whole lot of, but when you do, you know that you're just in for a good time. That's what this entire run has been. But thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. The best way to support my channel here. We went overtime for you on this Saturday afternoon, so hopefully you enjoyed it. I hope you had a great start to your Saturday weekend, and you got some amazing things planned this week. You got a lot of good Isaac runs coming up, and lots of fun streams to watch. So thank you again for watching, everyone. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. I really do appreciate it. And make sure you give extra special thanks to the patrons who make supporting this channel possible, which I will be reading in a second here after Delirium is done teleporting all around and turning into Bumbo and stuff. But yeah, what a run. One hell of a run. Go play both of those runs and let me know. Report back down in the comments below. Leaving a comment is also a great way to support my channel. Thank you, everyone. Sincerely, I really do appreciate it from the bottom of my heart. As always, I will see you all next time. Until then, have a great Saturday. Have a great weekend, everybody. And I'll see you in the next run. Whew. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Triple Delta, Wiley McAvoy, Melamantito, Rabbit, Hunter Douglas, and Satrical. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, then check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find over at patreon.com/Sinvicta.